Brothers and sisters in Islam, the best advice a Muslim brother can give his brothers and sisters, the best advice a Muslim can give anyone who believes in La ilaha illallah and Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the advice to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by staying away from his prohibitions in the Quran and adhering to his commands in the Quran or on the tongue of his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's been narrated in hadith by Imam Ahmad that two of the greatest qualities that will admit a person to Jannah is taqwa Allah and husnul khuluq. To fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to have good character. And the best character is that one who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by implementing the teachings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his Quran and the teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his sunnah. To proceed, no doubt Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought to us in a few days to come, he has brought to us a time which has many benefits. It has many khayrat, it has a lot of goodness. It has a lot of barakat, it has a lot of blessings. It's got a lot of hasanat, a lot of rewards. And I'm sure each and every one of you know the days and the nights that I'm talking about. The time, the month of Ramadan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his beautiful names and his perfect qualities to give us each and every one of us that is here and each and every Muslim on the face of this earth the ability to witness Ramadan so we can come under the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam like it's been narrated in Bukhari and Muslim and all the other books of Sunnah. Man sama Ramadan وَمَنْ قَامَ رَمَضَانًا إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ Allahu Akbar. If the Muslims only had this one hadith to talk about the fadl and the benefits and the khair and the rewards and the status of Ramadan, if we only had this hadith, it would be sufficient. Where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, مَنْ قَامَ The one who witnesses Ramadan. The one who witnesses Ramadan, imanan wa ihtisaban. And he does it believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because these are the two qaids. These are the two conditions for the result that comes at the end of the hadith, which is ghufira ma taqaddama min dhanbih. So the one who witnesses Ramadan with iman and he endures the difficulty. He endures the difficulty that comes with Ramadan. Then the end result is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive him or her from all her past sins. And no doubt, Allahu Akbar, this is a great reward for something which is trivial, something which is small and minute, something which is a small sacrifice and your sins, your minor sins are expiated, they're washed away. Because Ramadan, brothers, how it's been narrated in another hadith, Ramadan to another Ramadan is kaffara, kaffaratun lima baynahuma, how the Prophet ﷺ says. So all your sins from one Ramadan to another Ramadan drop and they're expiated if you witness Ramadan with the correct tawheed. And you witness Ramadan and you endure those hurdles and those obstacles for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, attaining His mercy, attaining His ridwan, seeking and desiring from Him. So we are now at the verge of accepting or witnessing or entering beautiful days. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّ أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ The night of Ramadan. Going back to the first hadith, where the Prophet ﷺ says, "Man qama Ramadana imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbih." Imam al-Bukhari, when he placed this hadith, he placed it in the book of jihad. He placed it in the book of jihad. And some scholars say, just like when a person goes for jihad and he endures the difficulties of jihad, likewise is a person when he seeks in the last 10 nights of Ramadan and he endures those difficulties and those hurdles and those obstacles in trying to find the night of power, Laylatul Qadr. So we are now coming to a part, we are now coming to a time where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought to us days and nights of a lot of khairat and barakat. And if this is the case, then how should a Muslim prepare for these days and these nights that are to come? What was the salaf? What were their practices? What was their advice? What were their guidances on how we should prepare for Ramadan? In this khutbah, inshallah, we'll talk about some points that a Muslim can start to prepare and some things that he can keep in his mind before he accepts, before we go into these days, before we go into the month of Ramadan. The first thing that we have to prepare, we have to keep at the back of our minds, if we want to prepare for Ramadan, is that we must have Ramadan in high spirit. We must have it in high regard, and we must have it in high regard and high spirit. It's been narrated in Ibn Majah and Tirmidhi, or the other books of Sunnah, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Idha kanat awwalu laylatin min Ramadan." When is the first night of Ramadan? غُلِّقَتْ أَبْوَامُ النَّارِ. The doors of the fire of Jahannam, before that, صُفِّدَتْ الشَّيَاطِينَ وَمَرَدَتُ الْجِنِ. That the jinn, the devils, the shayateen, they have now become chained. And the maradatul jinn, and their aiders. وَغُلِّقَتْ أَبْوَابُ النِّيرَانِ or أَبْوَابُ النَّارِ. And the doors of Jahannam have been closed, they've been padlocked. وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ. And the doors of Jannah have now become opened because of the blessing and the khairat and the mercy of Ramadan. And then the angels, وَنَادَى مُنَادِي يَا بَاغِيَ الْخَيْرِ أَقْبِلْ وَيَا بَاغِيَ الشَّرِ أَقْصِرْ. And a caller calls, "O seeker of good, come." وَنَادِي مُنَادٍ يَا بَاغِيَ الْخَيْرِ. O seeker of good, come and do good. وَيَا بَاغِيَ الشَّرِ. O seeker of evil, أَقْصِرْ, stop. And then, وَاللَّهِ الْعَظِيمِ, subhanAllah. At the end of this hadith, look at how this hadith ends. The Prophet ﷺ says, وَلِلَّهِ عُتَقَاء مِنَ النَّارِ وَذَلِكَ كُلَّ لَيْلَةِ, subhanAllah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frees the necks of people in Ramadan, and that is every night. Every night, there's going to be from this ummah, people that we know and we see, maybe they're at work with us, maybe they're at home, maybe the link between you and that person is just maybe a WhatsApp call, a WhatsApp or something, and that person, his neck will be freed. Every night of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frees from the fire of Jahannam the necks of slaves, the necks of people that worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan with ikhlas and with tawheed. Allahu Akbar. That's a very great spirit. That's a very great way where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam encourages this ummah on having high regard and having high spirit. So much so that the Prophet ﷺ says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every night he's got people that he saves them from the fire of Jahannam. Another way of prepare, some of the scholars, when they talk about this hadith, they say when the Prophet ﷺ says in the hadith where the doors of Jannah, or the doors of the fire of Jahannam, they're locked. And the doors of Jannah are open. Some of the scholars, they say this is a sign that Allah, that a human, a man, a person in the days of Ramadan, he is further away from wrong, he's further away from the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To certain extent, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has closed the doors of Jahannam, so no one can enter it. And when Allah opens the doors of mercy, you are closer to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because he's opened the doors of Jannah. Another way we can prepare for Ramadan is for us to have high regard of Ramadan, to make sure, in contrast to the first way we can prepare, to have that high status of Ramadan. The second way we can prepare for Ramadan is for us to constantly worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every second, or in every statement that we can say, whether it's good, or sometimes even not to utter something which is bad. How the Prophet says in the hadith, okay, Al-kalimatu tayyiba sadaqa. When you say something good, it's sadaqa. And to stop and not to utter something which is going to harm or affect or cause sadness to your brother, to not say it is also a sadaqah. It's also ibadah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, going back to the first hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, look at how the angels, they say, ya baghi al-khayr, O seeker of good, come. O seeker of good, come and do good. And O seeker of evil, stop. And the Prophet ﷺ says in the first hadith, "Man sama Ramadan iman wa ihtisaban ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." That the one who fasts Ramadan with iman, enduring those difficulties for the sake of Allah, enduring those hurdles and those obstacles for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all his sins are forgiven. And seeing as we're talking about holding high spirit and making sure you constantly worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan, once a companion, next been narrated in Musnad Imam Ahmad and also Tabarani, once a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ya Rasulullah, ayyul jihadi afdal. What did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say? You got people that are now going to jihad. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, aktharuhum dhikran lillah. The ones that are on the battlefield and they're engaging in dhikr, those are the martyrs, those are the soldiers of Allah that are the best of the best. Then another question was posed to him. And then he said, and then he was asked, أَيُّ السَّائِمِينَ أَفْضَلُ. Which are the best fasters? The Prophet ﷺ says, أَكْثَرُهُمْ ذِكْرًا لِلَّهِ. The ones who are most, who engage in the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most. Those are the best fasters. Then he was asked about Hajj, and then he was asked about Salah, and then he was asked about Zakah. And the Prophet ﷺ kept on saying, أَكْثَرُهُمْ ذِكْرًا لِلَّهِ. The ones who are the most, or who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most. Abu Bakr told Umar, رضي الله عنهما وعن الصحابة أجمعين, that look at, so Abu Bakr told Umar رضي الله عنه, ذهب الذاكرون بالأجر. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu told Umar that the people that remember Allah, they've gone with the rewards. Prophet ﷺ says, أجل. Indeed. This is something for us to remember in Ramadan, for us to link our fasting, our siyam, and our qiyam, and our qira'at al-Qur'an, and our sadaqah. All these things to link it with dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because brothers and sisters, now dhikr is one of the easiest ibadat. You can do it while you're lying on your bed. Another, Ibn al-Qayyim, the great scholar Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawzi, rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, أن أفضل كل عمل أكثرهم ذكرا لله عز وجل. Ibn al-Qayyim says, the best, whenever people do deeds, the best of these people are the ones that remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most. فَأَفْضَلُ الصَّوَّامُ أَكْثَرُهُمْ ذِكْرًا لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. The best fasters are those ones that remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most. وَأَفْضَلُ الْمُتَصَدِّقِينَ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لِلَّهِ ذِكْرًا. And the best people that give sadaqah are those people that remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most. وَأَفْضَلُ الْحُجَّاجِ أَكْثَرُهُمْ ذِكْرًا لِلَّهِ. And the best people that go for pilgrimage are those ones that remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most. Another point, brothers and sisters in Islam, that we can help or we can prepare and keep at the back of our mind so we can prepare for Ramadan, is that Ramadan is a time where you have to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought this ayah, mentioned this ayah, He mentioned it in between two ayah of Siyam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Siyam in the Quran, He says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِ عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. Ramadan is a time now that you're expecting Ramadan, and it's 3-4 days away. Gear yourself, prepare yourself. Try, if you don't know how to make dua, try and do some research. And acquaint yourself. And teach yourself. Ask someone at work, ask someone that you know, that knows how to make dua, so that in Ramadan, you can set yourself a goal and you can make dua regularly, preferably every day. Because Allah, and this Ibn Kathir says on this ayah, that when they ask you, O Muhammad, where is Allah? Say, Allah is qareeb, Allah is near. Ujibu da'wata da'i idha da'an. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you raise your hand, He attends to you. He gives you what you ask for. When you raise your hand, فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. Let them do istijaba. Let them follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and believe in Him. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. So that they are amongst the people of rushd. They are amongst the people who are guided. But I'd like to add something on dua. If in Ramadan, if you're going to make dua, it's very important. And that comes to our fourth point on how we prepare for Ramadan. It's very important on the days that you got left to turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek true repentance from all your sins. Because brothers and sisters in Islam, sins take away the barakat of your reward, of your ibadat. And the hadith in Sahih Muslim, where the Prophet ﷺ says, أَشْعَثْ أَغْبَرْ يَمُدُّ يَدَيْهِ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ وَمَطْعَمُهُ حَرَامٌ وَمَلْبَسُهُ حَرَامٌ وَمَشْرَبُهُ حَرَامٌ أَنَّا يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ. A man, he goes on a journey, and going on a journey is one of the scenarios where your dua is accepted. And his clothes are filled of dust, signaling that this person is seeking to Allah in humility. وَدْعُوهُ خَوْفًا وَرَاهَبًا, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran. And now his clothes have been filled of dust, signaling that he now needs Allah more. And he puts his hands to Allah, he raises his hands. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, his food is haram, his drink is haram, his clothes are haram. How does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to accept? How does he expect Allah to accept his call? How does he accept? Or how does he feel that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to answer his prayer when this is his condition? So free yourself, brothers and sisters in Islam, free yourself from the rights of people that are on your neck. And if you don't have the right of people on your neck, you've got the right of Allah on your neck. You've got sins that you haven't sought repentance for. Before Ramadan comes, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek repentance. Because it's been narrated in hadith that لَلَّهَ أَشَدُّ فَرَحًا بِتَوْبَةِ عَبْدِهِ مِنْ هَذِهِ بِوَلَدِهَا. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he becomes so happy with the tawbah of the repentance of his slave. Then this lady, and he's referring to an incident that happened in Medina where a lady lost her toddler. She lost her son, small son. And she searched in the roads of Medina looking for her son. And the companions, they saw her looking on all the roads and looking everywhere for her son. When she found her son, she straightway picked him up. She hugged him. She kissed him. The Prophet says, أَتَرَوْنَ هَذِهِ طَارِحَةً وَلَدَهَا فِي النَّارِ. Can you see this lady throw her son in the fire of Jannah? They says, no, we can't see. This is Allah loves the tawbah of his slave more than this lady loves her son. Allahu Akbar. So, Ramadan is coming. And this is a time where you need to prepare for Ramadan by turning to Allah in tawbah. Ya ayyuhan nas tubu ila Allah tawbatan nasuha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls us to seeking true repentance. Seeking true repentance. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in one majlis, he would seek repentance 100 times. This is Muhammad ibn Abdullah. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one who was forgiven all his past sins and his future sins, he would, in one gathering, he would turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in repentance 100 times. Another way we can prepare for Ramadan is, and this is one of the most important points, if you truly want to prepare for Ramadan, this is one of the best ways of preparing for Ramadan, where you set aside the Quran, an English version or a version that you understand in any language, and you recite the Quran, contemplating and thinking and actively reciting the Quran. Because like how the Salaf said, Ramadan is a month of Quran. To such an extent where some of the scholars, the minute Ramadan would start, they would put all the other sciences aside and they would turn to the Quran. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The month of Ramadan is the month where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran. In fact, there's a hadith in Musnad Imam Ahmad where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed all the books in Ramadan. All the books were revealed in Ramadan. And the best book, the book that overrides all the other books, was revealed in Ramadan. Ibn Kathir says, the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran, which is the best book in Ramadan, that shows the status of Ramadan. And you see the link between Ramadan and the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the Quran. Inna hadha al-Quran yahdi lillati hi aqwam wa yubashshiru al-mu'minina wal-mu'minat. That this Quran guides you to alladhi aqwam, that is better. That is better. This Quran takes you to what's better. Because whatever we have in front of us, you've got something good and something better. And this Quran is the hidayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alif lam mim, dhalikal kitab hudan lil muttaqin. This is the book Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent with the hidayah. If you are not going to recite the Quran in Ramadan, if you want hidayah, and if you want to be amongst those people that are freed from the fire of Jahannam, and you want to walk out of your life, you want to walk out of that dark tunnel, if you want to find the solution to your problems, you cannot find it if you're not going to read the Quran. You're not going to find it if you're not going to read the Quran. The Quran is our hidayah. It's been described in the Quran as Noor and Shifa and Rahmah. So this is the time, brothers and sisters Islam, where you prepare for Ramadan by keeping either a dictionary, making sure you've got the Quran on your app, having, for example, reciting the Quran and having, for example, a copy of Ibn Kathir in English or in whatever language you read it in. And when you read, okay, look up some of the ayat that you're reciting. And you recite the Quran. And you think, and you contemplate, and you pause, and you reflect on what you are reciting. And the last point I wanted to mention is Ramadan. Brothers and sisters in Islam, now that we are preparing for Ramadan, also prepare to remove that animosity and that hate and that greed and that love for money from within our hearts. Because one of the things that the Prophet used to do in Ramadan, he was very generous. How it's been narrated in Muslim and Bukhari, with one of the companions, he says, "Kan al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ajwadu al-nasi bil-khayr." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the most generous in good. وَأَجْوَدُ مَا يَكُونُ فِي رَمَضَانِ حِينَ يَلْقَاهُ جِبْرِيلِ. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would be more generous in Ramadan when he'd meet Jibreel. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would meet Jibreel, and Jibreel would recite to him the Qur'an, would practice the Qur'an with him. And the Sahaba, they say, كان أجود من الريح المرسلة. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Ramadan, he was more generous than the passing wind. The passing wind, when you're walking on a hot day, and you just get this nice cold breeze on your neck or on your forehead, or maybe up your back, and how you feel. And sometimes that passing wind, it brings good. The Prophet ﷺ was more generous and more good than the passing wind, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And there's many ayat in the Quran, and many rewards, and many hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he encourages people to give sadaqat and to give charity. There's a beautiful hadith in Tirmidhi where when you give a sadaqah and a calamity is going to fall, calamity falls on you, the fact that you gave sadaqah, that sadaqah, okay, stops the calamity from falling on you. Ibn Qayyim mentions this in one of his books. So, Ramadan is coming. Ramadan is a time where you give sadaqah. And your sadaqah is increased in the month of Ramadan. And when you add on to that, doing it solely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and loving Him, and you're doing it out of you being grateful to Him for His favors, and His bounties, and His blessings over you. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the rewards of your ibadah. I'd like to pause on talking about Ramadan and try and advise the brothers and the sisters on the way a Muslim should conduct, a Muslim should live on this earth that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made. Because I feel that the message on preparing for Ramadan, inshallah, it's clear to an extent. What happened a few weeks ago, where we get Muslims killing innocent people, this is an ideology of kufr. And this is, Allahu Alam, this is also the starting point when people have this idea that it's halal and it's okay for me to go and just kill people. This is the disease of the Khawarij. This is the disease of the Khawarij, where no scholar of Sunnah on the manhaj of the Salaf al-Salih calls them as people of good. They're a deviant sect, and they will be deviant until Qiyamus Sa'ah, until the day of judgment. These people who kill other people without a right, these people are the enemies of Islam. And the Prophet ﷺ says, يَمْرُقُونَ مِنَ الدِّينِ كَمَا يَمْرُقُ السَّهْمُ مِنَ الرَّمِيَّةِ. These people that go and kill people, they come out of the fold of the deen, just like how an arrow comes out of the bow, how it leaves the bow. Another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ says, an authentic hadith, he says, if I see them, I will kill them like how Ad or Thamud or one of the nations was killed. So, a Muslim, and once the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his farewell Hajj, and there's a lot of wisdom, and there's a lot of the Sunnah, and there's a lot of points that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he emphasized and he highlighted on that day. One Hajj Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did, but the advice and the Sunnah and the knowledge that came out of their Hajj, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. And he emphasized certain topics. Certain topics the Prophet ﷺ emphasized. He emphasized the topic of brotherhood. How Muslims live with their brother. He emphasized this. And then he says, إِنَّمَا هُنَّ أَرْبَعَ. That they are four deeds or four sins. He says, and then one of the sins he mentioned is وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا, and do not kill. Do not kill. Do not kill. Add on to that the grave sin of killing somebody without a right. And these people that do this, Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they're innocent from these people. And these people are innocent from the deen. How the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, يَمْرُقُونَ مِنَ السَّهْمِ يَمْرُقُونَ مِنَ الدِّينِ كَمَا يَمْرُقُ السَّهْمُ مِنَ الرَّمِيَّةِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, مَنْ قَتْلَ نَفْسًا بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ أَوْ فَسَادٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَكَأَنَّمَا قَتَلَ النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا وَمَنْ أَحْيَاهَا فَكَأَنَّمَا أَحْيَى النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا. When you go and kill a person, okay, فَسَادًا فِي الْأَرْضِ, to make problems in the land, to make problems in the land, okay, بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ, and you kill the person because he hasn't killed anyone else. It's like these people have killed the whole of humanity. Another hadith in Bukhari, the Prophet ﷺ says, مَنْ قَتَلَ مُعَاهِدًا لَمْ يَرِحْ رَائِحَةَ الْجَنَّةِ, or he will not smell the scent of Jannah. وَإِنَّ رِيحَهَا لَيُوجَدُ مِنْ مَسِيرَةِ كَذَا وَكَذَا. That a person who kills someone, a person who has a pact, a mu'ahid, he will not smell the scent of Jannah. And the scent of Jannah is smellable, or it's, you can smell it from this and this distant. So these people that go and kill innocent people without them killing other people, okay, these people are the enemies of Islam. And Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they're innocent from these people. And these people are innocent from the Quran and the Sunnah. And it's very important for us to spread this, because this is our deen. When we die, this is what we took from the Sahaba and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muslims are not killers. We're a religion of peace. We're a religion of peace. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he propagated the deen with his character sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He propagated the deen with his sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He didn't propagate it by killing people. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم بلغنا رمضان, اللهم بلغنا رمضان, اللهم بلغنا رمضان. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم أصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا, وأصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا, وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا, واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير, والموت راحة لنا من كل شر. اللهم أصلح ذات بيننا, واهدنا سبل السلام, وأخرجنا من الظلمات إلى النور. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اجتناب وارزقنا اتباعه, وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا, وانفعنا بما علمتنا, إنك جواد كريم بر رؤوف رحيم. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.